Good evening. I'm so glad that I could arrive in time to see you before you leave. And I understand that you would like to know more about who I am and what I have done. But before I begin, I must say you look lovely this evening. You really do. And you have manners, too. But if you want to know about Mary McLeod Bethune, all my life I've worked with youth. I've begged for them. I've fought for them. I live for them. And I live in them. You see, their story is my story. My parents were former slaves. And of the 17 children, I was number 15. I was the first to be born into freedom. And that makes me someone special. Then one day, a woman came to South Carolina that wanted to start a school. And she came to our home. She felt that if there were 17 children, somebody should want to learn to read. Now, it was harvest time. And my father was not so sure that he wanted to release us to go learn from books. But my mother understood how desperately I wanted to learn. And since I made myself useful, that was my reward, to go learn what was in those books. And just as I did in everything that I do, I made myself useful. Everything that I learned, I brought home. And I tell you, there is no greater joy than to place the Bible in your parents' hands and teach them the words that they have been reciting chapter and verse all of their lives but did not know how to read those words. There is no greater joy than to help your father understand that the numbers that are being recited to him do not match the coins that were being placed in his hands. There's no greater joy than to help your siblings learn to read and have them at your beck and call. Yes, I did enjoy that. I then went back to South Carolina, Kendall, and I met this handsome man. Therein lies the reason my last name is Bethune. We married, had a little boy named Albert, and moved to Savannah, Georgia. Now, when in Savannah, I met a man who was a pastor from Palatka, Florida, Mr. Uggams. Now, he wanted to start a school in Palatka. Since this was my mission, I had to go. Even though Albert was only about a year old, we had to go. We went to Palatka, and we did start that school. The students came, and we took the school to the students. 2 or 3 days a week, I followed them into the fields, into the jailhouse, I even follow those young people to the juke joint. You know about juke joints? Well, you one of those little people that I talked to? I thought I recognized you. But God bless her soul. One child started singing, "Be not dismayed, whatever betide, God will take care of you." And another child joined in, and their voices got louder and stronger. And I had the idea to turn the lights on in the yard and put the spotlight on the clan. Now they didn't like that. And they heard this seemingly fearless voice of what must have sounded like 100 people singing louder and louder and louder. And with the spotlight turned on them, they turned and went away. The next day we got up, marched down to the polls, and our candidate won. Sometimes you have to do what you have to do. Bethune-Cookman College came about because, like most colleges, we had some financial issues, and so did they. Cookman was a boys' school, and I started Bethune Institute as a girls' school, and we decided to pull them together. Now, I would also say that the best name came first.